See one thing, if you have a clear idea about what you believe as you and what you talk about you, what you express as you and what you believe as you will attract that same kind of people around you and you will live completely ease. See, one thing, there is no such thing as morality. If you have the wrong ideas about morality, only then you need to hide what you are and you need to project what you want, what people want you. You need to project yourself as society expects you to be if you have the wrong ideas about morality. The only one thing you need to understand is just be what you are. This is the ultimate morality. If you lose some friends because of that, perfectly all right, nothing wrong. It is better to lose your friends than yourself. If you present yourself as your friends want you to be, you will lose you. You are more valuable than your friends. Understand? One more important thing. If you start talking about you, which is not you, by and by you will get confused. Who are you? Now really. See, whatever you speak continuously, you start believing that as a truth. That's a big difficulty. Really, take this as a simple spiritual practice and try to do. Just 10 days, again and again tell everybody that you are a honest person, you are a person with the truth, you are a person with the truth. Just continuously, even if they are not ready to listen, you talk. Just say, after 10 days you will start really believing it. And another one difficulty is, whatever you start telling, you start believing, and what belief you had about you already, if that is same, then you fall in tune. This becomes a spiritual practice. But what you are believing is different, and what you are saying now, if it is different, then there is a conflict between you and you. Whether to create conflict between you and you, or create easiness between you and you, is in your hands. Constantly, if you say something, you start believing. And the difficulty is, if your unconscious is already believing something else, you have difficulty between, war starts between your conscious and unconscious. One more thing, person who is established in truth will not have dreams. All dreams is a fight between your conscious and unconscious mind. Whenever the frequency of your consciousness raises, you will come out of your dreams. Conscious mind is waiting to overcome the dream state, and the dream state is waiting to overcome the conscious state. Your life is nothing but the struggle between these two. The moment your conscious mind rests, dream state takes over. And the moment your dream state is exhausted with the material, your conscious mind takes over. Understand? It's like if the dream state is exhausted, if it doesn't have any more material, no fuel, then conscious state takes over. If the conscious state has no fuel, dream state takes over. If both of them has no fuel, then deep sleep state, the sushupti, comes up. Your whole life is a fight between these three. Whoever is strong, whoever has got more samskaras, they rule you. That's all. If you are suffering without deep sleep, without sleep, means you are conscious and unconscious, means that you are jagrat and swapna, has got too much of samskara, they are not ready to relax, they are not ready to give space for your sushupti. They say enough, no, we don't need sushupti, we have enough fuel. We have enough of desires, we have enough of anxiety, we have enough of fear to create again and more scenes in front of us. One more thing you need to understand. What you see during the waking state, this auditorium, me sitting in front of you, your friends, the chair on which you are sitting, everything is created out of the same stuff in which dreams are created. Understand? Let me repeat once more. Whatever you are seeing now, this auditorium, the person who is sitting in front of you, and the person who is sitting next to you, and the chair on which you are sitting, everything is created out of the same stuff. Same stuff out of which your dreams are created. Now you have difficulties. Now you have a lot of difficulties. Are you for this only I am working from morning till night? No, no, maybe this auditorium is created out of the same stuff, but not my house and my car. No. Whatever you are seeing, whether in dream or in waking state, is created out of same stuff. Understand? I am just thinking what words to use to tell you the authenticity of this truth. Because this one understanding will put you on satya, will just put you on satya, the truth. One more thing, this one understanding will liberate you from all your anxiety and you will become the best manager. If you know you are creating your wealth, if you know you are projecting and seeing things around you, you can create miracles. You can make miracles happen around you. See, it's like any slide which is kept in front of a projector light becomes reality in the screen. It appears as a reality in the screen. So if you want to change the scenes in the screen, going and scratching the screen will not work. Or trying to fight with the lights will not work. Just do a small correction on the slide. It is done. Your life is just like that. Projector light is your consciousness, and the slide is your samskaras, and the screen is the life which you are living. Now you are fighting with the screen or the light beams. You are trying to push the light beam. No, no, move, move, move. But you don't understand, you can't even grasp it. Fighting with the screen is not going to work. A small story. One guy fully drunk came back to house late night and fell on the way. But he doesn't want to create any sound. So he came very politely, silently, entered the house, covered himself with the blanket, but suddenly realized blood is there all over his face, ran to the bathroom, tried to put bandage, tried to dress himself, put some medicine and bandage and everything. So came back, somehow managed to sleep. Next day morning, wife started shouting at him, "Fool, did you drink and come last night?" He said, "Drinking? Why?" He started acting. He doesn't know anything. He is innocent. "No, no, 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 no. How do you know I drank and came?" "No, I came a little late because there was too much work in the office. She said, no, I can be sure you are drunk. You are drunk. He asked, how do you know? How can you be sure? Because you put the bandage on the mirror, not on your face. Seeing the mirror, he put all the bandage on the mirror. Understand, you working with the outer world is nothing but putting the bandage on the mirror. That is not going to heal you. That is no way going to help you. No. You may have an idea that you have put some bandage, you have put some medicine. You may try to sleep with the idea that you will be okay by tomorrow morning. No. Working with a beam, light beams, is not going to help. Fighting with the screen is not going to help. Just do little small correction on the slide. And I tell you, doing small correction on the slide needs intelligence. That is where the problem starts. You do not have that much of sensitivity looking to your life that you are creating it. You are projecting it. You are expressing it. Because you never connected and verified all the outer world incidents and your inner world thoughts. You neither gave that much time to yourself nor had the intelligence to connect and see. Sitting, connecting and seeing how your thoughts are creating your world is what I call meditation. People come and tell me, Swamiji, in meditation I am getting too many thoughts, what to do? Please understand, meditation is not trying to create thoughtless state. It may happen in the end, but when you sit in the beginning, you will not have thoughtless state and you are not asked to meditate immediately to get the thoughtless state. No. Whenever I ask people to meditate, first thing I expect them to have is thoughts which creates intelligence. Thoughts which creates clarity and the thoughts which gives life solutions. First, in the beginning when you sit with yourself, you will have only these things inside you. You will not experience thoughtless state immediately. You will have pratyagara and dharana. Only then dhyana will happen. In the beginning when you sit, you will, all your problems will come up and you will start having life solutions. All the thoughts about solving your problems, you will have that clarity. So I tell people, even if thoughts are not disappearing, don't stop sitting. Because first time when you sit with yourself, it's like appointment with yourself. All the things which needs to settled, all the things which needs clarification, all those things will be happening inside you. You will be falling in tune with Satya. You will be falling in tune with the truth itself. Here, Mahavir is giving beautiful sutras, beautiful teachings to measure some idea or some truth is Satya or not. Understand? He is not teaching you to speak truth. Because if you position yourself in Satya, if you are established in Satya, speaking truth will be an automatic thing. It will become a natural thing for you. If you are practicing just verbal Satya, please understand, that is not the ultimate Satya. If you are practicing only verbal Satya, any time you may escape from it.